Dear students, in previous class we already discussed about how to find out relative field intensity of a line charge using Gauss law. And we see that in the previous class for line charge we are considering a Gaussian surface, a cylinder, and also we follow the four steps to find out the relative field intensity. Now same here also we follow that same four steps to find out the relative field intensity using Gauss law. Now what is the step one? Consider a Gaussian surface now see, for point charge we are picked for what? Sphere. Now this is your point charge. Let us take this point charge is Q. Now we are considering a Gaussian surface sphere. Now this is the sphere. Now let us take, this is a small portion ds. Now this one is the electric field intensity E, and this one is the area vector A. Now you see, now this is the plus Q charge which is in the center of the sphere, thus it will equally spread the field intensity to the all the surface of this sphere, equally spread. That means here E, here also, if you take a small portion here, here also it will be E. This is the area vector A. Similarly, if you take a small portion here, here also it will be E, and this is the area vector A. So like this, you can calculate the value of E and A. So you are considering a Gaussian surface. Now we move to the step 2. Define E and theta. Now you see, E is same for the sphere. E everywhere, E is same. So you can say E is constant. Now, what is the value of theta? Now for this small ds, A and E are having same direction, so theta is equal to 0 degree. So we can write down here the angle theta is equal to 0 degree. Then move to step 3. Now we want to calculate what? Step 3 is calculate charge inside the sphere. Now see, here the total charge inside the sphere is how much? Q. So you can say the total charge is equal to how much? Plus Q. Now step 4, apply Gauss theorem to calculate E. So what is Gauss theorem? Close integral E ds is equal to Q by epsilon naught. Now this implies, so we can write down here integral surface E ds cos theta is equal to how much? Q by epsilon naught, which is equal to, now E is constant, E and cos theta are constant, so we have taken outside, close integral, close integral ds is equal to Q by epsilon naught. Now we know that this close integral ds is nothing but your what? Area of the sphere, surface area of the sphere. So this implies E cos theta. Now what is the area of the sphere? 4 pi r square is equal to Q by epsilon naught. This implies, now this cos theta is how much here? Theta is 0. So E cos 0, 4 pi r square is equal to Q by epsilon naught. This implies cos 0 is equal to 1. So E Q by epsilon naught. Then E is equal to how much? by epsilon naught into 4 pi r square. Now this is the derivation of electric field intensity due to a what? Due to a on charge using Gauss law. Now this equation also we get in electric field intensity chapter using Coulomb's law, and this is the same equation we get here using what? Gauss law. You can write on here E is equal to 1 by इसको अगर डी अरेंज करेंगे तो 1 बाई फोर फाइव एप्सिलॉन नॉट क्यू बाई आर स्क्वायर. द सेम इक्वेशन वी गेट हियर. नाउ हियर क्यू इज व्हाट यू कैन राइट ऑन हियर क्यू इज इक्वल टू टोटल चार्ज इनसाइड द स्फीयर. So this is the all about your electric field intensity for point charge. Next class we'll go for electric field intensity of a plane sheet using Gauss law. Thank you.